It's only a small portion of your screen, but it can have major impact on the look of your app. I'm talking about the status bar. And a lot of people have been asking me, how can I change the color? How can I change the looks of the status bar in my .NET MAUI application? Let's go find out. Status bar is like the small bar at the top of your screen, which has like your clock, your battery indicator, some other icons, the Wi-Fi signal, all that stuff. That's in there. And inside of your app, you can style that thing. So on Android, it usually has like the primary color, I think. You can set it in your styles.xml. On iOS, it actually isn't really a concept, but you can kind of fake it by just putting some colored thing behind the status bar, because you can actually draw behind the status bar on iOS. But how cool would it be if we had some easy way to do that for you? And now we have in the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit version 1.3.0 at the time of recording. It has just been released, and we now have a status bar behavior. And you can dynamically change the status bar color. You can give it like the light text or the dark text. You can do, actually, let's just go check it out. So here we are in Visual Studio 2022. I just created a .NET MAUI app, file new .NET MAUI, and I already installed for you the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. So if you don't know how to do it, go to the Solution Explorer, right-click on your project, do Manage NuGet Packages, and you need to find the Community Toolkit.MAUI. So be sure to get that one, and you need at least version 1.3.0. It can be higher if you want, but 1.3.0 is the version that introduced the status bar behavior. Now, if you've installed that, it will come up with a little README. You will need to initialize it in your mauiprogram.cs. Add this line here, use MAUI Community Toolkit. You will have to add this using statement here at the top, and you will be all set to use all the goodness. There is actually a lot more in the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit, so check out the playlist that's popping up on your screen right now for more .NET MAUI Community Toolkit content. But for now, we're focusing on the status bar. So we've got all of this in place. And what we can do now here in our main page, because you can do this per page, right? But it also kind of works if you just set this once for one page and you don't touch it again, it will automatically still have the same color throughout your application. So you can also just set it once. So what you want to do is here do content page. Actually, you can just do page. It doesn't really matter what the actual class is here, the content page. You can just say page.behaviors, because it's still a page, right? It inherits from page, the content page. You can just say page.behaviors. And here you can add that behavior. So we can say MCT. We need to add a little XML namespace here. And we can say status bar behavior. So we got that in place. Now let's see if IntelliSense can help us with this one. Quick actions doesn't seem to work. Okay, I'll do it manually. XMLNS, MCT is, and you need to find the community toolkit. And it's somehow it doesn't suggest me the right one here. So I'm just gonna go with these core.views. I think that is like something that is makes sense. And we don't need the core.views. Actually, this doesn't make sense. Okay, I'm sorry. I should cut this out. and I should do here behavior. So make sure that you get the right one here. I think this looks right. So the XLR namespace is communitytoolkit.maui.behaviors. In the assembly, communitytoolkit.maui. I hope the IntelliSense will help you better, but this is the one that you should be looking for. And now you can see all the squigglies go away. And the status bar behavior has two properties that are important, namely the status bar color and the status bar style. So the status bar color, it's easy. You just set the color. Let's just set it to pink, and our status bar should be pink. And we can set the style, which is interesting, which we can set to default or dark content or light content. And that means, like, you know, whenever you choose a lighter color like pink, you probably want to have the dark content, because then the text on your status bar will be dark. And otherwise, you can choose a light content and the letters and the stuff on the status bar will be light. So you can play with that even as well. But this, you know, you can just set it like this. That will style your application and you can be done with it. But what we can also do is these properties are bindable. So you can use this with MVVM as well. You can say here binding, and you can bind that to a property. color, doesn't matter. You can just do that and play with that through your view model. That's fine as well. Or you can just take this all away and do it from the code behind, kind of like the lazy way, isn't it? And you can say X name, status bar, let's just name it like that. And now I can reference it from my code behind, right? So I can set status bar. And well, here in the constructor, let's say status bar dot color is colors dot pink, and I'm gonna set the style just so you can see the difference, the style to whatever it is, to the dark content first, and then I'm going to do this, and whenever I click the button, which is the default button in the template, I'm just going to reuse that one. I'm going to set this to red, and whenever you use red, you probably want to use the light content because that looks better, right? So we should see pink whenever we're going to start this now, which I'm going to do right here, and with the dark content, so with the dark letters on top of it, and then whenever you click the button, it should go to red, the status bar color, and you should get the light content, right? So that's what we're about to see. Now, while we're waiting for this to deploy, this works on Android and iOS. Mac Catalyst and Windows are not supported at this time because they don't really have the concept of a status bar. I think Windows kind of have. And if you have some, you know, something, some idea on how to implement this, it is the Community Toolkit. So please come to the repository. The link is down in the video description, and open an issue, and even better, open a PR with the code to actually help us out here. So here you can see our Android app is coming up, and we see the pink status bar with the dark content, right? And whenever I click the button, it's going to go to red, and it's going to make my content white. That's how easy it is. And now if I don't change anything, so if I navigate to a new page, let's just do navigation.pushAsync, and I'm just going to do new content page. So just a blank page, doesn't really matter. You will see that whenever I do that, I can use .NET Hot Reload. So I don't even have to restart my debug session. And I click it again. You can see that it keeps the color, right? So, well, of course, this is still here. So let's just comment that out. Do this again. But whenever I do this, you can see that the color stays the same, right, throughout my application. So if I just do this once, it will stay the same in my application, no worries. If you want to set it to somewhere else per page, you can do it in code, you can do it with MVVM, with bindings, you can do all of that. This also works on iOS, I already mentioned. For iOS, if you want to switch between the light and the dark content, you will need to set something in your info plist. So go to your platforms folder, iOS, and then in your info plist, I'm going to open with the XML editor because the graphical editor doesn't have the right properties here. And you can just add this entry. I'm going to copy and paste it here from off screen. You can just add this one. So you need to add the key. This UI view controller based status bar appearance, and set it to false, because else iOS will try to automatically set the light and dark appearance based on the view colors that are on the screen. Basically, you want to disable that functionality, you want to override that and take care of that yourself. So leave that in here. And also for Android, if you look closely at when the application was starting, so maybe I can still show you that if I go back. But I'm probably going to have a lot of apps here in my overview, but let's see if I can get it up here. It still has this color, right? So this is the primary color, I think. So if you want to get rid of that, because this behavior can only do something at runtime, right? When it's executing our code. If you want to change that, you will have to go into your Solution Explorer, Android, your resources, values, colors.xml, and I think it's this primary color. You should play with whatever these colors are, maybe change them and see which one actually changes it. But whenever you change this one, that will also have impact on the rest of your application, maybe where these colors are used, but that should also impact the status bar color. And if you don't want to use the behavior at all, I think this is how you can set the status bar color for Android for your whole application as well. So free pro tip right here at the end of this video. And this is how you can style your status bar in a .NET MAUI app. So I hope this has been useful to you, because I'm not kidding when I'm saying I got this question a lot. How can I style the status bar? This is a very easy way to do it. And actually, let me know down in the comments how this works for a .NET MAUI Blazor app, especially on iOS, because on iOS you had this weird behavior where your Blazor page would go behind your status bar. It didn't really look pretty. I've been meaning to implement something for that, but I think this might actually be a solution for that. So try it out. Let me know down in the comments if that actually works, or if you want me to make a video on it, of course, that would work as well. Make sure to like this video if you've actually liked it, so that it spreads to more people can learn about this wonderful functionality in the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. Thank you so much for doing that. Subscribe to my channel, and I'll be seeing you for my next video, but not before I point you to this playlist with more .NET MAUI content, this video that's recommended especially for you, and this button so that you can subscribe to my channel. See you for the next one.